Hi, I'm Mike, the field engineer with America's Generator. Today we're going to talk a bit about what to do if your generator doesn't start. A few key things to look at to make sure you're focusing on the right problems to get you to the right solutions. Okay, the first thing we're going to want to check is our batteries. Want to make sure it is fully charged and connected properly. Located on either side of the generator in the battery tray, we want to check to make sure our connections are secure. Negatives and positive connecting. Being secure and your battery is fully charged and ready to go. The oil dipstick is located on the other side. So next we're going to talk about your engine oil level. Your dipstick is located on the side of the engine blocks. What you would do is remove it, give it a wipe, and you're going to reinsert and check that your level is at the correct reading. Okay, we're all good to go. Engine oil is a check. So let's talk a bit about fuel-related issues. What we want to do is make sure that your fuel tank is filled to the appropriate level. If you have previously ran the engine out of fuel, it may require bleeding the air, and you don't necessarily want to run your engine out of fuel because that could cause damage that you'd have to take care of. You know, may involve replacing a fuel filter or other components in the fuel system. So again, make sure your fuel is at the right level and your fuel system is primed. Another really important thing we want to talk about is your coolant level. Can it cause issues for your engine? Yes, it can. You want to make sure that your radiator and cooling system is filled to the appropriate level. On some units, there is an alarm associated with your coolant level. Some units, there may not. Again, it is just a regular service item, but sure you've maintained proper coolant level for the operation. The next thing I want to talk about is how your controller can help find out what's going on with the generator. It's a very useful tool in troubleshooting any issues that you may have. All your fault codes are logged in your alarm log on your system. You'll be able to see what's actively going on. And through the event log, you'll be able to see what's previously happened. That'll give any technician or anyone troubleshooting a system a good idea and a good starting point where to attack a problem. Mike, field engineer with America's Generators. We talked a bit about what could go wrong with the unit, where to start. If you like what you heard, please subscribe below. Join us for future tips. If you have any problems and you can't figure it out, always feel free to give us a call here at America's Generators. Enjoy your day and remember, hot Florida.